Now, in Brazil, the pandemic is one of the world's most severe, and health workers there have now urged the International Criminal Court to investigate President Bolsonaro's government, accusing it of crimes against humanity over its handling of coronavirus. Almost 2.5 million cases have been recorded since March, and more than 87,000 people have died. And the pressure may be easing in Brazil's big cities like Sao Paulo, but concern is now growing for smaller towns and cities in the country's interior, where healthcare services are rather more basic. Our South America correspondent Katy Watson reports from Campinas, which is a town 100 kilometres from Sao Paulo.
It's a virus on the move, heading to areas that had time on their side as they watched the big cities struggle. Yet they too have found themselves unprepared. Retirement homes have been badly hit by COVID-19 in recent weeks, but this one is trying not to become another statistic. They've had to be creative about keeping their residents active, and so far it's paid off. There haven't been any cases.
The situation is really worrying. It's been the worst month of the pandemic here in Campinas, so we have doubled down on isolation. But it's exhausting. There comes a time when we can't let the disease take over, this horrific situation we're experiencing now.
It was a while before the virus took hold here. In fact, authorities reopened shops, thinking the worst was behind them. But then hospital beds started filling up, so they closed them again. And doctors don't think the situation is going to get better anytime soon.
Every bed in this intensive care unit in one of the city's public hospitals is occupied. And Dr. Marta is worn out. She likens her life to swimming. She wonders when they'll be able to come up for air.
People come here in denial. Only when they find it hard to breathe do people start to believe that it's real. And it's really sad to see people short of breath. It's distressing. That's when people start pleading, "Doctor, don't let me die."
Fabio admits his family felt the same before his father, Salvatore, died last month. 8 members of the family contracted the virus in all.
It took everyone by surprise, even the timing of events. It was a week and then we were asking, "Where's our father? What happened?" He went into hospital without any pre-existing conditions and never returned.
Back at the care home, they're all too aware of this silent killer, and they're offering a compromise for families desperate for a hug. Elsa hasn't had a cuddle from her children for 4 months now. This is the hardest part of isolation for everyone. For daughter Chris, it's everything.
Ah, that felt wonderful. It's been so long, I cannot touch her, hug her, not even get close to her.
This is the land of warm embraces. Brazilians thrive on affection, so even the care home staff take advantage while they can. Katy Watson, BBC News, in Campinas.